Hey guys, it's me, Lo here. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm doing a video in collaboration with another small YouTuber. Her name's Sarah Dillon. I hope I pronounced it right. Sarah Dillon. I think that's how you pronounce it. But I'll have her channel linked down below in my description box. Make sure you go and subscribe to her and watch her videos. She posts really cool videos, not only about makeup either. She talks about, advice for like college freshmen. She talks about just daily adventures that she goes on. She vlogs a lot. So make sure you go and follow her. And she also does post a lot of makeup reviews as well. So today we're doing both a drugstore foundation review. So I'm doing the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. And she's doing the Milani Perfect Conceal and Perfect, the like concealer and foundation in one, which I already did a review on. So if you want to see my review, go and check it out. And go and check hers out as well. And she should be posting around the same time as me. So today, like I said, I'm going to be doing the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. So it looks like this. So that's what I'm going to be doing today. Now this foundation has gotten like a lot of hype over the last few. Well, since it's come out really. It's got a lot of hype as being a really good drugstore foundation. It's only $6, so like super affordable. So that's one thing that's just like straight off the bat really, really awesome. But first, I'm going to prime my face using this e.l.f. hydrating primer. So I'm just going to prime my face because I didn't do that yet today. Okay, so now that I am all primed, I am going to apply the foundation. Just like in any other foundation review that I've done, I'm going to be applying half of it with a brush. I'm going to be using the NYX Total Drop Control brush, which I really like, and then just a sponge on the other side, which is really dirty and probably needs to be cleaned. I don't really have a mirror, so I'm just going to be using my mirror from this. Okay, so I have used this a few times before, so I can give you a little bit better of a review on it. But it has like a spatula instead of like a pump, which I mean, at least they give you something, right? If it's a drugstore brand, usually they just, you know, make you pour it on your skin. But this, they at least give you a spatula, which is actually pretty easy to apply. It's kind of easier in a pump, in my opinion, because you don't have to get your hand all dirty with the foundation. So I'm just kind of using whatever's on the one spatula worth. And I'm in the shade Soft Beige. And I think if I remember correctly, they did have quite a bit of a shade range. So first I'm going to use the brush. I'm going to do the side of my face, my right side. I'm going to go ahead and try to blend that out. It's blending pretty easy so far. I wouldn't say it's full coverage or anything. I think it's more like a medium coverage in my opinion. I don't know what it claims to be. Yeah, I think it's just supposed to be light to medium coverage, which I agree with. I don't know if you can build it up. I think we're going to test it. So far, it's blending out pretty nicely. I would have to say, even with my hydrating primer, it's a little bit drying on the skin. So if you have dry skin, I wouldn't necessarily recommend this. But I'm going to go ahead with the Beauty Blender, which is not a real Beauty Blender. It's a little bit harder to blend now that it's sitting on my face for some time. So I would recommend like doing your face like in sections maybe with this foundation just because it is a little bit, it dries out pretty fast on your skin. I think this side with the sponge gave me a little bit more coverage than the side with the brush. I think it gave me a little bit more coverage on this side, but I'm going to see if it can like blend it, or not blend, build up at all just because I'm curious. So I'm going to take a little bit more on my spatula. And I'm literally just going to put a little bit more, see if it can cover up my moles. Because that's always my test, if it's buildable or not, if it can cover up my little moles. But yeah, I definitely would say this is buildable. It's actually really nicely buildable. If you guys can see that, it did cover up nearly all of my moles. Overall, I think it's a really nice foundation. It is a little bit drying, I would have to say. Like, after some time, I feel like this does dry out my skin a little bit as I wear it throughout the day. But it doesn't get, like, cakey or anything. It just kind of feels a little bit drying on my skin. But I have dry skin in general, so it might be different for other people. It might be really good for oily skin then, because it will help your skin not get so oily throughout the day. But it does say that it's supposed to have really good, you know, camera abilities. Like, when you, like, it shouldn't have any flashback, basically, is what it claims to be. And I would say that I would agree with that. Whenever I've been in pictures with this foundation on, there is no flashback. So it really does do that. So that's really nice about it. I would say it oxidizes a little bit from when you put it on. So I would maybe go one shade lighter than you normally would, because it does oxidize just a little bit. But for $6, I mean, you get this nicely finished. It's pretty much matte, I would say. But like I said, it's a really nice foundation for $6. It comes with a spatula, which is kind of cool, actually. I kind of really like it. I wish, like, more foundations would have that. But I think overall, it has really nice coverage. It has really nice satin finish. It's not sticky on the skin. It feels very lightweight. I really only have that one complaint about how it's a little bit drying. But when I put more on, it feels more hydrating when I build it up than just the one side. So maybe it just dries down a little fast. But so I think overall, though, just make sure that you apply in sections, because it does get harder to blend. Yeah, but I really like the finish of it, actually. I think it's a very nice satin velvety type of finish. It's not, you know, it's a little bit blurring, actually, to be honest. But yeah, it does oxidize and it does dry out your skin a little bit. But other than that, it's a perfect foundation with the flashback, with the coverage, with the finish. I really like all aspects of it. So make sure you go and pick this up, and make sure you go follow Sarah on her channel. And I know she would really appreciate it if you send her love from me. So make sure you go and do that. And I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed watching it. And subscribe to my channel down below with the red button. And I'll catch you guys next time on my channel.